I'm now ready to take your questions.
Thank you, sir. The first question will come from Joyce Panyares of the Manila Standard.
Sir, can you just give us an idea of the formula that you're using for wealth sharing?
Wealth sharing, the provisions are quite broad now. The formula is not yet specific, but the principles are there in terms of the wealth sharing. So wala pang specific formula. The framework agreement contains principles. Ang susunod na pag-uusapan ng mga partido ay yung tinatawag na mga annexes. The annexes plus the framework agreement contains the entire package, which we are now calling the comprehensive agreement.
Sir, Chairman Murad issued a statement and he said na parang this would be a greater challenge now is the implementation. Parang how do you see this agreement being implemented in light of the elections next year? How will you be able to ensure that the new law that would be required to craft that Bangsamoro entity would be passed?
The agreement was that the ARMM elections continue in 2013. We did not touch that in terms of the negotiation. After the framework agreement is signed, the idea would be to issue an executive order creating the transition commission. We of course know that the transition commission will be recommending a draft bill to both houses of Congress. We are of course informed that the general plan for the transition commission is that consultations will happen within the area that will be included within the prospective Bangsamoro, and therefore people will be engaged, and therefore they will have expectations, and therefore after the draft is actually completed, it will then be submitted to the House and the Senate. It is there where there will be further deliberations on the proposed basic Bangsamoro, the Bangsamoro Basic Law, and hopefully by that time there is enough political momentum, not only from the present administration but also from the people in the area, to move in order that the bill sails through both the House and the Senate. We are expecting, of course, that the Transition Commission, while they are doing their work, would be engaging the legislature as soon as they are created. The ARM will continue to govern the region. The ARM will continue to govern the region. As soon as the law is passed and ratified, then therefore we will now have a new law governing that particular area. To us, it is the equivalent of an organic act in the Constitution. Remember that Republic Act 9054, which creates the ARM, is also an organic act which passed through a similar process. Therefore, when the new law is enacted, it will replace the existing ARMM. So that is the process. What is our assurance? Peace agreements are political commitments made by one party to the other. Although we can put numbers, we can put dates in the agreement, in the ultimate analysis, it is the good faith of both sides. It is in the good faith of both sides that the agreement is implemented. Of course, this is a political compromise that is struck with the MILF. And as you can see, that compromise is constitutional. It is inclusive. It is people-driven. And it will undertake a lot of consultations with the people that will be included in the region that is called the Bangsamoro.
Sir, last na lang. Does it help your cause that it appears that Mujib Hataman is running unopposed for ARMM governor? And can you tell us yung facing ng normalization?
Mujib Hataman has, I think, issued a statement that he is supportive of the framework agreement and supportive of this process. And that is all that I can say. I do not know if it's election period, so may I not say more than that. I will just say that he is supportive of this, and we welcome more support from those that are running for governor of the current ARMM. After all, who is not for peace? With respect to normalization, at least what was struck were the principles of normalization and the agreement that the timetables for decommissioning and an annex on normalization will still be further negotiated. Please look at the section on normalization. You will see in paragraph 5 a commitment by the MILF for gradual decommissioning. I think this is the first time that they have made that commitment in on paper, and they will sign this agreement. Therefore, there will be a gradual decommissioning of MILF forces until they are put beyond use. Then the next statement there is logical. In an area where it where there is insurgency, where the armed forces of the Philippines is so deployed, then certainly as we normalize, it can be logically inferred that the armed forces of the Philippines will transfer some of its law enforcement functions to a reformed police. As you know, our Philippine National Police also is undergoing a transformation program. This agreement adds to that by creating an independent review commission of experts to make recommendations from their own knowledge, as well as, of course, collating information coming from the public in order to be able to find a way that our existing police in the area would become more effective, more efficient, and more independent and professional and community-based. So I think these are the parameters of the normalization. So the timetables will still be negotiated.
Mia Gonzalez of Business Mirror.
Sir, based on the section on transition and implementation, can we take it to mean that the government is open to constitutional amendments to implement the agreement?
There is a provision there which says that part of the powers of the Transition Commission would be to work on proposals for amendment of the Constitution, but there is no commitment there that such proposals are going to be acted upon by Congress. Like every citizen, Article 17 is open of the Constitution. Any citizen can make proposals to amend the Constitution. Any group of citizens, in fact, may cause a petition for initiative in order to amend the Constitution. Any group of citizens could lobby Congress in order to pursue a constitutional amendment. So they have requested, the MILF have requested, and we have said, why not? The Transition Commission may tackle that, may discuss that, may even propose it, but it is up to Congress to so amend the Constitution. As far as we are concerned, insofar as the major political commitments that were made by this administration in that framework agreement, we see no necessity for now to amend the Constitution. We think that the commitments made there by the government is indeed within the parameters of the Constitution, or should I say, within the flexibilities of the existing Constitution.
Sir, and is it right to describe the Bansa model as an amended ARMM?
I think what they want, what the MILF, what that representation wants to say is that they want to replace the entire ARMM. Of course, realistically, we should understand that there are already institutions within the ARMM. There are local governments there, and if you notice, the local government structure is not touched. And therefore, it is important for us to understand that it is a replacement of the autonomous region in Muslim Mindanao. You see, in political negotiations, the language of one party is different from the language of the other. The language of the government of the Philippines is, of course, the language that we find in the Constitution in our Republic Acts. The language of the Moro Islamic Liberation Front is their language. And as you can imagine, as we are working on a draft, it is important to remember that a peace agreement is a political document. It is a document that lists the political commitments to each other in order to reach an end state. And that end state is a situation that will be beneficial to all the peoples there. Therefore, I will not read the peace agreement as if it were a very strict legal document. I would read the peace agreement as a set of political commitments made by one party to the other. And therefore, of course, it will be signed by Mohagher Iqbal, the chair of the MILF. It will be signed by the chair of the government's negotiating panel. As far as I remember, I am not a legislator. I only derive my authority from that of the president. The president will not sign the agreement, nor will it be signed by the chair of the MILF. This is a political commitment by the representations of these two parties. I will not read the agreement in a very strict legal sense. Again, I will repeat, there is language of one side and language of the other. If you want to strike a bargain between the two so that both are in the same roadmap towards a more peaceful accommodation of their interests and end decades of war, then therefore we will have to accommodate the language of each other in order to reach that kind of a framework agreement.
Sir, last. Sir, would a peace deal in any way reduce the threat of the MILF breakaway faction in the Abu Sayyaf?
Well, Abu Sayyaf is not MILF, and therefore the peace deal, regardless of the peace deal, there will be those kinds of threats. There are other armed groups in the area, and with respect to the other armed groups in the area, they will be treated as law enforcement problems. And therefore, the army and the police, supported by the army, will continue to lay down law and order in that area. In areas where the MILF may be present, there will be a coordinating mechanism, and that is also contained in the aspect of normalization, building upon our existing ceasefire arrangements. Please remember that from the from January 1 of this year to today, there has absolutely been no skirmish between the MILF and the government. As a matter of fact, there have been cooperation de facto between the armed forces of the Philippines and the MILF in to implement certain activities in order to get certain objectives of the Philippine National Police and the armed forces of the Philippines.
Michael Ubak of the Philippine Daily Inquirer.
Sir, on the possibility of amending the constitution, you said that as far as the panel is concerned, you work within the parameters of the mandate given to the president, and that in effect refers to the constitution, the powers given to the president. But the framework agreement speaks of a ministerial form of government,
yes,
which will necessitate, I guess, an amendment to the constitution.
No, it does not. If you read the Article 10, which contains the provisions on autonomy, the provisions of autonomy are found in sections 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, and 21. There is nothing there which says that a ministerial form of government in an autonomous area is prohibited. In fact, the wordings there, part of the constitution is very sparse. The discussions in the Constitutional Commission point to the idea that there should be accommodated certain kinds of forms of government within the area, within a national structure. And therefore, I beg to disagree. There is nothing in the Constitution which prevents that area from having a ministerial form of government. Unless meron kang provision na naisip.
What do you mean by ministerial form?
Is it ministerial means that political parties will dominate, genuine political parties will dominate, and try to capture seats that are allocated, maybe to various geographical areas or probably representing certain sectors. And then these political parties will select who will execute, who will be the chief minister for now, maybe, who will act with the powers of the governor.
So not a parliamentary form of government within that area?
It is similar to a parliamentary form of government within the area. The Constitution says that whatever government is in the autonomous region, it shall always be under the supervision of the President. So therefore, even that...
Cotabato, how many barangays exactly?
The barangays that voted yes in the 2001 elections, at 2001 plebiscite for the approval of Republic Act 9054. I'm sorry that right now I do not have the number of barangays. However, again, core territory is mentioned there. But please notice that it is very clear that the two parties commit that there be a ratification of the Bangsamoro Basic Law and a plebiscite with respect to the core areas that will be included within, which means that even those that are currently under the arm will be asked again, do you want to be part of the Bangsamoro? I don't think that you can be more democratic than that. And the MILF being a serious partner to be able to find found a society that actually looks at pluralism and democratic values have agreed to that particular provision. So when the Bangsamoro Basic Law is crafted, the areas that will be included in the Bangsamoro Basic Law, yung nakalagay sa provision na yon, will be asked the question whether they want to join the Bangsamoro.
Sir, and also, how will this agreement address the structural violence in the area?
What do you mean structural violence?
The poverty, the historical atrocities between both sides.
Immediately upon our announcement of a framework agreement, there were many statements of support, not only coming from foreign governments, but also international organizations. Immediately upon the announcement.